Now that the Geant4 libraries are available in our hard disk, they can be used by an executable that can be launched by double-clicking its icon or from the command line. The executable can be compiled from a main function in a C++ file that calls other functions defined in libraries or other C++ files. A main function can be found in each of the Geant4 official example applications. There are 5 basic examples and a lot of extended and advanced examples. The first basic Geant4 example contains 13 C++ files with more than 400 lines of code, yet it only demonstrates a very simple application. Let's take a look at an advanced example for underground physics. It contains 46 C++ files with about 4,000 lines of code. If you are not familiar with C++, this is a little bit overwhelming. In order to help students who are not familiar with C++ to learn Geant4 quickly, I developed a Geant4 example application with rich features yet small footprints. It contains only one C++ file with 555 lines of code at this moment. It has very similar footprints as the first basic Geant4 example, yet it contains a lot of features that is practically useful for the fast implementation of small to middle-sized experiments. The only thing you need to do to compile theirs in Linux or Mac OS is to run a command called make in the directory where the gears.cc file is located. Assuming that you have a C++ compiler available for your system. If you have never compiled a C++ program in your Mac, please run this code to install the C++ compiler for the Mac OS. Be aware though, this command may take a long time to finish. To install the newly compiled Gears executable, you need to add this line to your shell configuration file in your operating system. This is to declare some of the environmental variables so that the operating system can find where the compiled Gears executable is located. Now you should be able to run Gears in a new terminal and run Geant4 macro commands in the user interface. You can also use a combination of ls and cd to browse all the available Geant4 macro commands. You can also use help to check the detailed usage of a specific Geant4 macro command.